So you want to easily find your conflicting or outdated mods or CC that you may have in your Sims 4 mods folder, then keep on watching. Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's so nice to see you. Today we are gonna be talking about this program over here, which is called Mod Conflict Detector, which basically tells you which CC slash mod are conflicting basically. So one specific mod might be conflicting with another CC or mod that you may have in your mods folder, so that's what I'm talking about. And by using this program, you can easily identify those stray files. And by stray files, I mean those zip slash rar files that shouldn't be in your mods folder, because you obviously need to extract them and then you need to place them in your mods folder. But before we get into this video, just a quick reminder, if you enjoy this type of content and if you find it helpful, please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, all that good jazz. Hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I'm uploading a new video, because it truly helps me a lot. Thank you so much and I appreciate you a whole lot. And so back to our video, we're gonna basically try to install this one even though it was last updated in 2018. I'm not questioning it, so we shall see if this works or not. But we need to go to this section over here which says files, and then we are going to download the top one over here. Do not download the third one. You are supposed to download this one if you use Windows XP. So in this case, I'm not. I have Windows 10. So we are going to click on this one over here. And then as you can see right here, it is a zip file. So in case you didn't know, you need to install an extractor program of some sort. For instance, I am using WinRAR, but you can obviously use whatever extractor type of program you would like to. You can also use 7-zip. But the important thing is to use an extractor program, basically. And so what I'm going to do is to actually create a folder on my desktop over here. So we are going to create a new folder and I'm going to name it Mod Conflict Detector. Once we've created that folder, we are going to click on this zip file over here and we are going to select all those things. We are going to open our empty folder, our new folder, and we are going to select all of these and we are going to drag and drop them in this empty folder over here that we've just created. And so it's really important to create an empty folder and to have all of these files in one place, because otherwise this program won't work properly if you don't have those files included in this folder. We're gonna click on this program over here and it's gonna open this window over here. So we're gonna go to scan over here and then we are gonna click on directory, scan the whole mods folder, useful for the routine checkup of all your mods basically. We're gonna click on it and as you can see right here, I already have selected the right path. So in case you didn't know, you need to select your documents, electronic cards, the Sims 4, and then mods folder. You can select your mods folder by clicking on this button over here, but I already have it selected. So we are gonna go and hit the scan button and see how it works basically. So as you can see right here, it is scanning all of our mods. And as you can see right here, you can go to colors legend over here if you don't know what this blue color means. So basically this blue color means that we have a conflicting mod. And so we need to remove the specific file that is conflicting with this Wilfred hair basically. If your files are highlighted in yellow, it means that your specific CC or mod is not conceived for The Sims 4. It is actually a package file conceived for The Sims 2 or for The Sims 3. So it's really important to pay attention whenever you're downloading CC. Make sure to only download CC for The Sims 4. If it's highlighted in pink, it means that this specific file is broken and you need to remove it from your mods folder ASAP. If it's highlighted in purple, it means that this specific file is a duplicate. So you basically have two copies of the same CC in your folder, so you need to remove the duplicate one. If it's highlighted in this light purple, it means that the specific file is disabled, which by the way, you can right click on it and you can click on this one over here and you can disable a specific CC or mod. So that is super useful. And you can also delete, you can also show this file in folder, you can also open it. So it truly comes in handy. You can easily delete or disable a conflicting or broken mod basically. And then if it's highlighted in that very pale orange, it means that your file needs unpacking or it is a wrong content. So basically, if you have a zip or a RAR file in your mods folder, you need to unpack it, you need to unzip it, and then put it into your mods folder. So I specifically put a file into my mods folder to see if this program was going to detect that specific file as a mod conflict, because I obviously have this Wilfred here, right? So this specific CC is not problematic at all. The only problem is that I have this merged to that package file. So basically this one is the conflicting file and this is the one that you need to remove. So what this merged to that package means, if you've watched my previous video, I'm gonna make sure to insert it. I've shown you how you can easily merge your CC using Sims 4 Studio to actually make your game run faster and load faster. So I was basically using that program to merge all of my CC and I didn't actually remove the individual CC. I mean, I have both options in my mods folder. I have the merged file with all my CC and I also have all of my CC in individual files, if that makes sense. And so this Wilfred hair is already included in this merged package. So that's why all of these, you know, CC appear as mod conflicts, because I already have them included in my merged version, basically. All you actually need to do is to remove this conflicting mod. So you can right click on it and you can click on delete. And then you can either select move to recycle bin or you can delete it permanently, basically. And so in this case, I'm gonna delete it. So you can either delete this merged version that you have right here, or you can delete this highlighted CC. Basically, you can also disable a specific CC, and as you can see right here, I have already disabled it because it showed up as mod conflicts. And so yeah, so as I said before, all of these CC appear as conflicting because you may have a similar mod or CC in your game, and so you need to remove one of them. Basically, you obviously don't have to do this, but if you encounter any issues or any problems in your Sims 4 game, and if a specific mod appears as conflicting, make sure to use this program and get rid of that specific mod slash CC that appears as conflicting. Basically, it should be highlighted in this light blue. Basically, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm actually gonna close this program and I'm going to actually insert an outdated mod to see if this program identifies it. So I am more than sure that I have an outdated version of UI cheats. So this is a mod. So if you don't know, this is a mod and we are gonna use this one that I downloaded in June. So, and I'm gonna do this on purpose just to see if this specific program identifies this broken mod, basically. And so we are gonna go to Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 4, and then Mods, and we are going to drag and drop those two files over here, which are outdated. As I said before, those were downloaded in June 2020 and my game is updated. I have installed that November patch. And so we are gonna open up this program once again. We're gonna go to scan directory and then scan once again. Well, this UI cheats extension scripts appears as incorrect content, basically. I don't know what that means. So it is a wrong content type. I don't know if that has anything to do with the fact that it's broken and it doesn't work anymore, but it still tells you something about this mod at least. So in this case, I don't think that this program is that accurate, and so you really need to pay attention to the mods that you're installing in your Sims 4 game, because it is quite problematic. Every single time you update your game, make sure to remove your current version of your mods and replace them with updated versions. It isn't that big of a deal, but in terms of identifying conflicting mods, this program is very, very useful. And we're gonna put a duplicate as well to see if this program identifies it. So let's say we wanna copy this Lila hair. We're gonna paste it and we shall see if it appears as duplicate or not. We're gonna click once again on scan. And so as you can see right here, that specific file showed up as has duplicates. And so you can easily right click on it. You can delete it permanently. And so you are good to go right now. You have successfully deleted that duplicate file. So as I said before, I wouldn't recommend this program for identifying broken or outdated mods just because it hasn't been updated in over 2 years. So that is quite problematic. But the best alternative that I can give you is to actually go to your documents, electronic cards, the SIMS 4, and then mods folder and see when this specific file was last modified or when it was downloaded, basically. So I have this UI cheats mod over here, which was actually downloaded in June 2020. I have updated my game with the recent patch that has been released in November 2020. So it's quite obvious that this specific mod is outdated, and so therefore I need to delete it. But in terms of finding conflicting mods in CC, I highly recommend using this program if you are experiencing issues with like CC and mods in your Sims 4 game. And so this program is quite good, I must say. But if you still experience issues with CC in your Sims 4 game, the best tip that I can give you is to actually move your entire mods folder to desktop, open your game, and then a new mods folder will be generated in your Sims 4 folder, basically. And so all you need to do is to copy your old CC that you have on your desktop in small batches, that is super, super important, in small batches to this new one, and open your game every single time you place CC in your mods folder to identify the problematic CC, basically, and to remove them. And you need to keep on doing that. And by that, I mean you need to keep on adding CC in small batches into your new mods folder and open your game every single time you place them. Try to identify the problematic ones, get rid of them until you completely move or transfer all of your CC or mods. But anyways, you guys, that was all for today's video. Truly hope you find this video helpful. And if you did, please make sure to subscribe, like, comment, all that good jazz. Hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I'm uploading a new video, because it truly, truly helps me a lot. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next Friday or Tuesday at 2 PM Eastern Time/7 PM UK time. As always, have an awesome day, just like you. Bye, guys.